A quick video. I still have this. I know. I think I mentioned elsewhere. I was going to take this off the bench until I get the Pentagon socket. Okay. Well, I wanted to do a video. I promised I would earlier today. And basically, what I want to go over is the mechanism. So right now, I'm at this rectangle for the stitch length, and then I'm at. Let's just go to red dot rectangle. And I'm down here on the, let's just do red dot, just a straight stitch. And so zero stitch width, minimal stitch length. I forget some of the stitches. I should know this and I forget. I think zigzag, it's not necessarily zero. It's still a little bit, I think, at least. I hope I'm correct. I think that's right. I think that's for the red settings. I think that's right. Okay, so I want to go over this whole reverse mechanism train. So we already know down in here, this clunky, you know, that's literally that clunky sound the machine's going. But what's triggering that when we're on these reverse stitch settings, or even here, if I decide to say, okay, let's just watch. I'm going to switch this over to S, M, or L. And pay attention to this little lever right here. Switch it over to M. It's L, M, and S. And there's probably some kind of travel. I don't really know exactly. But what's going on is this is now is going to engage with this lever. I'm just going to look over here. This lever over here, and this is where the issue, I suspect, is going to happen once I get the timing on my machine. Suppose I'm going to do it down here, but I guess I could right up in here. But there's a cam over here, and that finger follows a cam that's underneath this cam stack that's related to triggering the reverse. So if now you see I'm on the S setting, and so that would be a white stitch that's going to trigger reverse. And I'm probably preaching to the choir here. My apologies if I'm redundant. You already know, but just to kind of make certain that, you know, others do, you can see as I rotate, now all of a sudden you see that reverse mechanism move. And so there it goes back again. And that's going to be what that clattering is. It's literally that little point right there. I think that's what it is, hitting on the, I think that's a stitch selector. Is that the length? Yeah, it's a stitch selector. The stitch length dial. So it's this dial here. So that's moving in and out. And you're going to have, that's going to be, you know, clunking it. And it does. I think it helps being oiled more. You can see on my machine, this one that came in all greasy and it was pretty seized up. I think it's oiling, if I remember right, with this one, though. There's a gearbox on the underside where you can see that black area back there. The super lube, I think, is what I hear, is the PTFE, and I suppose they use, many use a tri-flow as an oil now. I'm not a big PT, I don't like fluorinated stuff, if I can help. It's bad enough if I use the corticoid steroids, the Flonase and whatnot, because my allergies. You know, that's my choice I put in my body. I don't know if I want fluorinated compounds everywhere else, though. You know, I don't know. Maybe I'm overthinking, because they're amazing products. I know they are. So I'll try to use the silicone, though, or just natural refined mineral oil. So I'm sticking with Baby Love right now. So this is the Baby Love. This is mainly for cleaning. And it's a really lightweight. You can see how lightweight that is. That's lighter than the medical grade stuff you see at the pharmacy. I mean, that's like water. Not really. It's a little thicker than water, but it's 99.5%. Lightweight mineral. I don't know the exact CST yet, but it seems very low in that 20 CST range. And sewing machine oil is 9 to, I think, 23 CST. So it's got to be right in there, that zoom. So Zoom might be a little lighter, the Lily White Oil. So I have some of that upstairs. I just haven't really used that on any of the machines yet. I've only been using the Baby Love, and it's working great as an oil. And mainly that little 0.5% lavender oil, probably be a little bit of a solvent, or less. So, I mean, I don't think that's much, you know, it's not going to hurt anything, especially cleaning. But yeah, you can see as this rotates around, see that finger's moving on cam, and that's going back this little train here to this lever. This lever is what engages, you can see down below, that reverse stitching. So my thought is, seeing that you got that bent up, you thought it was bent up. You know what? I haven't looked from a top view. Mine's that funky surface also. Not funky, excuse me. It's a triangle, that angle. So maybe yours isn't bent. So there's probably nothing wrong with that being bent. My guess is something's stuck in there. So I'd try moving this around. See what can disengage. You know, something's still engaging. If you're on the red dot, and you're getting, see, that should be loose, right? So this should all be loose, and there shouldn't be any of that. You know, that should be back further. So you see, it rotates around. That should be all away from it, not following that cam. Okay, and then another thing that might help get that out of the way, I'm wondering if you had a similar issue. See how that kind of pops up? So, you know, that's going to be popped up out of the way. You see how that finger's out of the way? So basically the hole causes reverse mechanism. You're not going to have anything seize up. You see how loose that is? It's supposed to be really loose. You saw how loose that spring's supposed to be eventually. It took me a few days, and I did a little heat too, and 99% isopropyl alcohol, I suppose, carb cleaner or something, you know, do that outside, we'll loosen that up too a little quicker. Heat with oil will loosen that up quicker. Mine was all stuck up, and I mean, this is goopy, greasy, nuts mess. So, yeah, that's even worse, maybe, but I don't know, I'm guessing something got that, you know, when you're on the red dot now, and any of the stitch lengths moving. My concern's gonna be getting in there. You see how moving that moved in, the shorter stitch length, the longer stitch length that moves out, and travel should be back further, it looks like. So, and they shouldn't have that reverse action going on. That reverse action is going on because this is coming in there and doing that. So that shouldn't be doing that. So check it out and see if that's stuck. That point there is a grease point, oil point. Just douse that with oil. You know, I mean, I'll show you what I do. I just do this. I go where it's not even, I grease every little point. So like I go around, I put drops of oil around every little point and get that all like oiled up, you know, because you want to get all that down in there everywhere. These little handy needle spouts are a nice little, I use these for electronics. You know, actually, I still have 99% isopropyl alcohol in there, and I got some of this for the deoxit, they call it, for contacts. Actually, I've got a little bit for, I got a little one for flux that's used for soldering, but then I said, well, you know, I've got an extra one of these, and that's like a bigger, I think they use them for vaping or something, refilling also, but they're a larger diameter. It's probably not going to show. I can look to and find out for you, but it's a really handy little directed spout. You know, if you need a little pressure, this isn't enough. I got syringes too, or for the electronics, so you can push it faster and kind of spray in and dilute that red deoxit stuff with isopropyl alcohol. And it's, instead of spending much money on the can spray, you know, I'm saving a little bit because I got the, you know, these are free. Most of these were my Sears Kenmore, the most I paid. I only paid for one, and that one I paid $10 for. The rest were free. Now, these ones, these whites, you know, I spent money on. They weren't all free. There's some free ones in there, but, you know, I spent some on, you know, what is it, $25 on that with a cabinet, $10 for that one, $20-something, $24 for this one. But anyways, the point is, try not to spend too much. I just went and rambled a bunch. I hope that wasn't you know, off topic too much, but let me see down in here. There's another pivot point you want to look at down in there too. Make sure you get oil on that pivot point. I oil the springs, you know, these springs over here, get oil on everything. I mean, it's not going to hurt anything. And you see what I do is I take these salad lid containers, because this is like, these are executive desks. I've modified, like I took the sides, I put under my workbench, put another desktop on top of that, and made a little smaller desk, and I took the bigger one and put there, and put the, these are actually rescued me in the USA, Stowe and Davis, desks, executive desks, and figure they're in pretty rough condition on top, and I'll just go and use them as my electronics workbench where I only have that there, and kind of turned into a sewing machine addiction thing for the time being. But yeah, I'll get back to electronic stuff, and I think I had HVAC work I was going to do too. I needed some more tools for that. But so every little point where you see on this little train here, it's a mechanical train, that needs to be oiled really well. So something's not down here. My guess is this lever somehow is causing that reverse thing to do that. And I'm guessing now, after I've looked at this, you're not going to have an issue with that being bent or messed up. It's just going to, you're going to need oil and stuff up in here. You know, some of this, literally, you just go back and forth over and over and over a bunch when you're oiling, too. When you're getting that oil down in there, do this. You know, go back and forth with your dial as you're oiling so you get oil work in there. And just feel. It should be kind of smooth, you know. This is going to be not smooth to me, at least. But it's still smooth, but it's not as light. Where this dial is really smooth to me. This is still pretty smooth, but it's not as light as this. This kind of pretty easily going. Now, this is going to be a little more, you know, it's not that stiff, though, either. So even there, all that, you know, you just keep moving, you know, changing that width. You know, you see all these mechanisms. You open that up, you can see these mechanisms moving, and you just move them as you're oiling, and that'll help oil in. I'm not the expert at this. All I know is I've been successful in unsticking all my machines, and the only one so far was this one. Well, I don't think any of the other ones I'm going to have issues with because they're all metal. But this one's got the plastic inside, plastic gears, had everything loosened up, and I got too eager. Warning, warning, warning on videos online. Be careful with this. Be careful with that. And, you know, what did I do? I stripped it. So I messed up. That's going to have to now be completely disassembled, at least this stitch pattern selector gear mechanism and whatnot. Otherwise, man, that is an awesome machine. Amazing. That was a free one, too. But, you know, just take care. Don't push too hard if there's issues. But if it's moving, you know, keep getting that oil in there. You can't get too much oil, is my opinion. I think even machine tooling, we learned oil, emmer oil or something like that. I don't know. It's not English, so I don't remember it. But you oil them. And you put your paper towel, put you a rag, put you something plastic underneath, get you a baking pan or something. I do that for my lawn and garden mechanical projects. I don't do that for electronics so much. Getting nervous with static electricity. But, you know, you can put a pan, like a baking sheet or something like that, or a cookie sheet or something underneath. I started doing that a little bit too. So lay out your parts if you disassemble. It's more, but, you know, mainly here, it's just that oil. You don't want to get a mess on everything. And that's about it. I costed 12 minutes. I costed 12 minutes of your time. My apologies. I'm not going to edit this. I'm just going to post this. I don't know if I'll make it public. Maybe I'll share it privately. I don't know. Anyways, I'll probably post it. Take care. Be safe. Stay healthy. Comment down below if you got any questions. You got any suggestions. If I'm talking out of my, I don't know what I'm talking about. Worked for me, but you're the service person. You know what to do. That's best. Please comment down below. Don't be afraid. Don't be shy. Whatever I'm learning. This is a learning experience for me. So thank you for asking questions. Like and subscribe if you want to. Helps the channel grow. I'm not super concerned about that, but it's kind of neat to see that kind of grow. Otherwise, be safe out there. Stay healthy, especially if we got a storm coming in. You know, take care. Bye for now.